In this example, we are going to experiment with position. Position is a way to specify where you want a certain element to be, and there are a number of different values for the position attribute that CSS allows us to specify. Example 17 will focus on using the position attribute correctly to achieve the look and feel that we are interested in. So we'll start with the same example that we saw earlier. Many of our examples will build on top of those, so it's important for you to have understood it correctly. The Lunicon author site. The first thing we are going to do here is to add a header strip to the top of the site. This is like a band which spans the entire browser window. This is a very standard design in new age web pages. Facebook has it, whole number of web pages have it, LinkedIn has it. This is the standard header strip. This is the look that we are trying to achieve with our web page. We want a standard header with our logo. This is what we want our web page to look like. Notice the full header band in our standard Lunicon color at the very top. Here is what the bare bones HTML for this page looks like. Remember, we are building on top of the previous example. So most of this example is very similar to the previous one. Notice the logical unit, content, and the footer. The content and the footer layout is exactly the same as earlier. The footer has the clear right, the navigation bar has the float right. So none of that has changed. What's new is the content header. This is the header of the page that we've just added, and within it is the logo. This is the header right on top. We place it as the very first part within the body element so that it appears first. Remember that HTML renders the elements from top to bottom. We want the header to appear on top, which is why we place it as the first element. So right after the body tag comes the header tag. And here is the CSS for the header. The CSS basically says the header has a specific background color, it has a fixed height, and it spans the width of the entire browser, which is specified by width equal to 100%. Width colon 100% basically says whatever the size of the browser window, expand this element to fill the entire width. This little bit of HTML that we added in right to the very top of all the other HTML elements is enough to get a header strip at the very top of our web page. But what if we wanted the header to remain at the top even as we scroll down the page? So we want the header to be fixed at the top of the browser window even as we are scrolling down. You can see this on screen. We've scrolled a little bit. The header remains even as we scroll. Note that our image overlaps and it goes under the header. The header remains even as we scroll. How do we accomplish this? CSS gives you a way to accomplish this very easily. You simply add two properties to your content header CSS class, which applies to the header strip. Position colon fixed, top colon zero. These are the only two properties you need to fix the header such that when you scroll down, the header remains fixed to the top of your browser window. We fix the position of the element using these two properties. Every element has a default value for the position property in CSS. The default value for every element is called static. This, when you don't specify the position property in CSS for an element, the default value that it assumes is static. Position colon static basically means that place me as per the HTML rendering. that element is placed based on other elements in the regular HTML flow, which we spoke of in earlier classes. So it will be laid out left to right, top to bottom, depending on the element. If it's an element which requires a line break, it will be placed on a new line based on the HTML flow. That is what position static means. When we use the term position colon fixed, what is the position fixed at? So what are we fixing this position to? Fixed to what? That's the question. This is where the second property that we added, top, comes into the picture. Along with top, bottom, left and right are also properties that can be specified with position colon fixed. Top colon 0 basically means that you want to position this particular element at a certain distance from the top of the viewport. The top specifies the distance from the top for that fixed element. Bottom, left, right will similarly mean distance from the bottom, distance from the left, and distance from the right. The position is fixed relative to the viewport of the browser. The viewport of the browser is basically all the parts that you can see on the browser, the visible portion of the browser. So these two properties mean fix the position of the header at the top of the visible portion to the user and make it 0 pixels from top. The top, bottom, left and right properties can be specified in pixels, in percentages, which form relative distances, or it can have specific values like auto and initial. Whenever you need to use the top, it's best to have a quick glance at the W3Schools reference to understand how we can use top correctly. Just as we fixed the top header, it makes sense that the bottom footer should be fixed to the bottom as well. This way, the browser viewport or the portion of the web page visible to the user will always be flanked by the header at the top and the footer at the bottom. So important information in the header and the footer will always be available to the user. So it'll be at the bottom of the screen rather than the footer being at the bottom of all elements. Go ahead and update the CSS for the footer to include the three properties that you can see on screen. Position colon fixed, bottom 0, width 100%. This basically says that the footer will be fixed to the bottom of the viewport, bottom of the screen. Its width will span the entire page. And bottom 0 means 0 pixels from the bottom of the viewport. And here is what the final result looks like. This is the web page with the header and the footer, both of them fixed to the top and the bottom of the page. And here is how the web page looks on screen. Note that you can move the bottom portion of the browser up and the footer still remains with the viewport. The same thing with the top. You can scroll and the header will remain within the viewport. So here it is. You can scroll, the header and the footer always remains in view. So if you have important information to convey within the header and the footer, this layout works well in your web page. What else can you do with the position property in CSS? So far, we saw position fixed. There is another position value, that is position absolute. Position absolute means that particular element will be positioned with respect to the nearest position ancestor. If you remember your HTML, elements are nested one within the other. So if you position a certain element, it'll backtrack its parent tree and find the nearest positioned ancestor. And if there isn't such an ancestor to be found, it will be positioned with respect to the body element. That is position attribute. You may not realize it, but position absolute elements are very common indeed. And these are used when you want the element to have a fixed spot on the screen, even when the page scrolls. So you want the element to be, say, at the center of your screen, and even after scrolling, it will continue to remain at the center. It's like those annoying ads which pop up at the center of your screen and you just can't seem to make them go away. Those are positioned absolute. This is different from positioning within the viewport, at this position in the viewport. This is at the center of your screen. Another valid value for the position property in CSS is position colon relative. We've discussed earlier that every HTML element has a specified position as it's being laid out by the browser. The default position is the one that's specified only by the browser's flow. When you apply position colon relative to an element, it is positioned relative to the position it would have occupied in the regular flow of the browser. This is relative to the original position that this element might have occupied. And once you add position relative, it is affected by the top, bottom, left, and right properties, just like position fixed. This position colon relative changes the position of the element relative to the normal layout which HTML would have followed to lay out that particular element. Don't be confused with the presence of a whole bunch of position attributes. The best way to learn these is to try them out. Try them out and see whether they get the result that you want to achieve.